Okay, the today's session is computer systems and software, the unit from the level 4 IT, and the present students are like Nicholas and I myself, Dr. Ajaz Sumro, and we start with, and as I already explained, that there is a sequence of the units in order to go ahead with any particular level 4 or level 5. We will be following the particular sequence, like these units, computer systems and software management and information systems, relational database management systems, and all these in that particular sequence, right?
Okay.
So basically the unit, computer systems and software, that unit is a core unit being taught anywhere in the institutes, universities, so that before the students, they learn or work on any units, they should have some know-how about everything about the computer. Make sense?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, sure.
Yeah. How? Because you will be dealing with, like, understanding the components of computer system, yeah, understand the computer software. So whatever the components you know, and whatever their names are, you should really be able to understand them. It may be the case that if the people might know that, okay, this is a computer, people might know that this is a CPU. Do you know where is the CPU in a computer system?
Mm-hmm. On the motherboard.
Yeah, but normally people misunderstand the tower. They think that this is a CPU.
Oh no.
Am I right?
Yeah.
Basically, that's their interpretation. They say that, okay, this is a CPU, and because they mean that this is a central processing unit inside.
Mm-hmm.
They keep the keyboard and mouse separate, and they keep the monitor and printer separate. So normally they say that's a CPU, but CPU is basically the central processing unit located mm-hmm. on the computer. So this unit tries to give you some information regarding the components and hardware of the any computer, as well as the learning outcome 2 gives an information about the computer software. Yeah?
Yeah.
So we will be covering all these, you know, indicative content terms and maybe more. And I hope that you should have access to the Moodle as well. Yeah?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I do.
And you should be able to have a look on these, the learning outcomes and the unit specification, as well as you should be able to download the PPT slides, the one that I will be, you know, teaching you from mm-hmm. those PPTs, as well as, you know, the any other, you know, material that will be available on the Moodle as well. Yeah.
All right. Yeah.
Okay. So let us quickly start some of the, you know, slides. Computer systems and software, learning outcome 1, understanding the components of a computer system. Simply, a definition of the computer is that any device that can compute or calculate is known as a computer.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So calculator and computing that can compute is basically a computer. Normally, you can say that any, for example, the mobile is a computer. Any chip or any small micro devices, they can be called as a computer. Yeah. So yeah. Whichever has a capability, even normally the smart TVs, yeah, they run the internet, they are computers.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So they have a capability to compute anything. So computer is a device that accepts data in one form and processes it to produce a data in other form.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. A computer is capable of processing data and information fed to it can be arranged presented in more easily understandable and useful form. So anything that we do manually as compared to the computer, computer has a more arrangement, presentation and understandable form that we, you know, get benefit from it. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah.
Whatever the definitions you will be, you know, explaining about the advantages of the computer, you will get a lot. Yeah. So system component types, major components of the computer, they are normally the hardware and software. A computer's hardware consists of electronic devices, the parts you can see and touch. The term device refers to any piece of hardware used by the computer, such as keyboard, mouse, and modem, etc. So mm-hmm. anything that you can touch physically is a hardware. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Software, also called program, consists of organized set of instructions for controlling the computer. Some programs exist for computer use to help it manage its own tasks and devices. Other programs exist for user, enable the computer to perform tasks for you, such as creating documents.
Mm-hmm.
So which are the programs that control the computer?
Like a service host exec, or I don't know. Even the Windows.
Not the Windows, but Windows itself. The mm-hmm. term software, when you say that two types of the softwares, one of them which control the computer and others which you know the manage or help you to use the other softwares. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So the Windows itself, the operating system is the software which is used to control the, you know, the hardware of the computer. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So simply hardware, the parts that you can touch, the software, it can be a operating system. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Or it can be a general software like MS Office or others.
Yeah.
It's in simple definitions. So whenever somebody asks you these questions, you should be able to memorize these definitions straight away by memory, by heart. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
That what the definitions are. They can always help you to explain in an interview or wherever you are needed. And these are very basic things. But if you don't remember these by heart, then, you know, you will not be confident enough.
Mm-hmm. So, So in that question, I say Windows.
No, you said a software can be of two types. One is mm-hmm. the system software. Another is the application software.
Hmm.
The system software helps you to run the computer because Windows is a system software. The utility programs like, you know, the antiviruses and the defragmenters,
mm-hmm.
the other utility tools that you use to, you know, run or manage a system, they are also the system software. And the application softwares are used for the user purposes, for their specific tasks. Is that clear?
All right.
Yeah. So hardware normally is when we say that central processing unit like this, you know, box. This mm-hmm. this is not the casing of the computer, but you can assume that there is a motherboard, and on the motherboard there is a CPU, like the input devices like a mm-hmm. mouse and keyboard is connected with that particular central processing unit via the motherboard. Output devices like a monitor, printer,
mm-hmm.
is connected to the CPU, and normally the CPU has some components like a control unit, memory management unit, and arithmetic and logic unit. So
mm-hmm.
there are some parts in the processor again. Yeah. Control unit, memory unit, and arithmetic and logic unit. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
So control unit controls transfer of data between CPU and memory and CPU and input output devices. Make sense?
Yeah, of course.
Arithmetic and logic unit performs arithmetic computations and logical comparison operations on data. Make sense?
Yeah.
Like arithmetic, like, you know, the computer itself, it works on, you know, the binary data.
Yeah.
You know the binary data? Like, you know, that computer doesn't understand any of the language like 1, 2, 3, 4 are English language, but internally it works in the zeros and ones. So when the machine language works into the zeros and ones, then it is further given a layer to the low level language, and that particular low level language makes some operations of the arithmetic like addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, as well as the logic operations like greater than, less than, equal. So all these operations are performed into that particular arithmetic and logic unit of the component of the processor. Memory holds instructions, data, and intermediate and final results of processing. So whatever the instructions are being used, the data and the whatever the intermediary data is being used, and any of the final results, they are processed, they are stored into the memory. And the motherboard, as I already explained, connects all the components of the computer and allows peripheral devices for input. So peripheral devices, the external devices, and output,
like the mouse, keyboard, stuff.
And output, secondary storage, communication to communicate with the system unit. Large flat board covered with sockets for the chips and other control boards. So it's a board, circuit board. Memory types. There are two types of the memory: main memory, primary memory, and second memory or backing storage device. Sorry, you know that I am going through this little bit quickly. And because these are the basic things, you might know. You know these already, and we have to complete these 28 slides, you know, by 12 o'clock. And at any point, if you don't understand from these, terms, then you can ask the questions.
Although I am familiar very much with the terms.
Yeah, that's why, you know, I'm going little bit, you know, faster. So main memory is basically the. There are two types of the memory, memory. RAM, random access memory, and other one is the ROM, read-only memory. The RAM is a volatile, holds the data and instructions temporarily as long as the computer is switched on. Amount of RAM in a computer determines which program will run and how efficiently. For example, Excel 2000 needs 20 megabyte. Extra is needed for data and other applications. For example, the other programs like Photoshop might need a better memory. If you will be using the Photoshop, probably the more the RAM you will have, and you will be using the software very quickly and properly, isn't it?
Indeed.
So, but remember that the programs, they run and sit into the RAM, random access memory, that's a volatile. And the ROM, read-only memory, it's a permanent, holds data and instructions even when the computer is switched off. Can you give me an example of the ROM?
The hard drive.
No. Remember, we are discussing the main memory.
So the ROM. Would be inside the central processing unit. ROM.
So was I correct initially? that if you don't know these basics, yeah, even you know the computer, the fixing and everything, yeah, and you know, these minor things are very, very important.
Yeah, then you are correct, yes.
So, have you heard about the BIOS?
Yeah, the BIOS, okay.
The BIOS is basically the ROM.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah?
I knew that, but...
Yeah,
anyway,
so that's, it's permanent, holds and data instruction, even when the computer is switched off. You configure the settings of the computer, and they that is used for, you know, for probably any of the configuration of the system. Is that right?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yeah. So again, there are some types of the ROM. One is the programmable read-only memory, and another is the erasable, you know, programmable read-only memory.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So what happens? Normally, the ROM is fixed. Yeah. And it is permanent, but still you are able to save it, you are able to change it, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
So
yeah, I can make the changes in the BIOS.
Yeah. Sorry?
I can change things.
Yeah, you
the
can
BIOS,
change.
So, yeah.
So again, it's not necessary that it's always the desktop and you have, you know, option to press the F2 and enter into the setup. Yeah. And that's basically the programmable. And sometimes you need a kind of memory chips. They are not you know, erasable. Yeah. They come like with, for example, any chip of the ROM of the, you know, iPhone, for example, then it may not be possible to override by yourself.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Because when you say that iPhone, you can say it's a computer. And it is computer, basically. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Any phone today that you have that comes with a processor, comes with a RAM. Yeah. So you are now clear that a main memory has a two types, RAM and ROM. RAM is, you know, volatile, changing, and ROM is permanent, and two types of the ROM. Yeah.
All right.
Secondary memory is our permanent storage device. There are two types. One is the sequential and another is the random access memory. Can you give me an example of the sequential access memory?
I suppose that's the hard type. But about the random access, no, I'm not familiar with the term.
You said that this and the sequential access is device or hard drive, yeah?
Yeah.
But no. As the name implies, a sequential access device is basically a device that is used in sequence only. Have you ever seen a tape drive?
Tape drive, like the floppy.
Maybe, no, not the floppy even. Have you seen any audio cassette?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, audio cassette, video cassette, and previously some big tape drives were used to store the data. Normally, if you have a, you know, the tape drive or any audio cassette, the data is stored on that particular, you know, tape, isn't it?
Oh, yeah, hence the sequential, yeah.
Yeah, so no, that's right, the sequential.
No, I get it.
Yeah,
now I get it.
And the random one is basically the hard drive.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So that's the difference between the random access device and the sequential access device. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So, like secondary memory, primary types of magnetic storage, like magnetic tape, diskettes, that's also the, you know, we are talking about the magnetic storage, basically.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? The magnet is the magnetic tape, the diskette, hard disk, high capacity floppies. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So apart from the magnet, is there any other type of the secondary storage?
Apart from the magnet.
Yeah.
I don't know, DVDs or flash drives.
Which what?
DVDs, Blu-rays, the flash drives, like the USB hubs.
To some extent, but let me explain.
Mm-hmm.
So secondary memory is a permanent memory. Yeah.
Yeah.
There are two types of the memory, like when you say that magnetic tape or magnetic material,
mm-hmm.
basically the hard drive that you have, been dealing in earlier days, it is an electromagnetical, electromechanical device.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Because the hard drive has a mechanical, heads as well as electronic device.
Mm-hmm.
Is that clear to you?
Yeah.
The conventional hard drives, they are basically mechanical as well as electrical.
We're not talking about SSD, right?
I'm coming to the SSD later on.
Okay.
Yeah. When you say that you are talking about the secondary memory or backing storage device,
hmm.
one are the sequential one are the tape drives or tape drives or magnetic tapes or big records. Yeah. And the random one, like you can access directly like in the hard drive.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You don't need to run any, a kind of reader in sequence. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So the topic, this point is, over here. Next point is that what are the types of the secondary storage? Okay. Probably they are like, magnetic one.
Mm-hmm.
Another are the optical. Yeah. And probably the third one can be the electronic one.
Okay.
Yeah.
Like the cloud or? Mm-hmm. Okay.
Now see, does it make a sense? One
yeah,
is the magnetic
sure.
one. The magnetic
mm-hmm.
one are basically the electromagnetic.
Okay.
But not everything, but magnetic, like the data is stored on a magnetic material.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. The magnetic tape is only manual. The diskette is manual. Hard disk is electromechanical. Because
mm-hmm.
in that particular hard drive, the component to read the magnetics or is itself the electrical, yeah?
Yeah.
The second one is the CD-ROM. They are called the optical storage, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
The data is stored into the optical bits of the, storage. The CD, the CD drives, it doesn't have any of the magnetic material, but they have an optical material.
Mm-hmm.
Is that clear?
Yeah.
Yeah. And the third one, you can say that flash drive and SSD drive, they are the electronic storage devices.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So in Broadway, the permanent memory can be a magnetic one, it can be an optical one, or it can be a pure electronic storage.
Okay.
Yeah, clear?
Yeah.
Now, measuring memory units, a bit. Memory units. Like when we say that, 1 pound, 2 pound, 4 pounds, one pence, 2 pence, 5 pence, 10 pence, 20 pence. Is there any 25 pence?
No, I'm not sure. No, I don't think so. At least as far as I...
Yes or no?
Like a single coin, I mean.
Yeah.
So it's comprised by a 20 and a 5.
Yeah. But there is no any 25, cent.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. The same way, a bit. Bit is the smallest non-addressable unit of memory, which a computer recognizes. A bit is an abbreviation of the binary digit, which may be on or off. It also represents 0 or 1. Yeah. Now, when you say that memory, now we are starting with a memory. What is memory basically? They are the blocks to hold the data. They are blocks to hold the data. So a bit is basically a one block, a one, spot, which can either store 0 or 1. When it is on, it is holding 1. And when it is off, it is holding 0. Yeah.
Okay.
So this is basically the non-addressable. Like, if I ask you that the place you are living, and you are, living in a room of, like room number 2 in a house. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So can you give me the exact address of that particular room instead of giving me the address of the whole house?
Okay, I'll try. If, let's say, if my house is comprised by 10 rooms.
Yeah.
Four rooms.
Yeah.
Okay, I would say I live in the room number 4.
Yeah.
So it would be 0001.
No. For example, what is the number of your house or flat?
51.
51. So basically... your room is inside the 51. Yeah.
Yeah.
Like bit is a room. It is a smallest unit of memory that is non-addressable.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Nibble is the group of 4 bits that is also the non-addressable. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
The byte, B-Y-T-E, byte is a smallest addressable unit of storage.
Okay.
Yeah. Like a house number, and word is like 2 houses, and double word like, more and more you are going towards the county and, city and many things. Is that clear?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah. So byte consists of 8 bits. Yeah. So the 8 bits can contain how many values?
8.
Yeah. 8 bits are 1 byte can store how many values?
One byte.
Yeah.
A character.
Hmm.
Alphanumerical or
numerically? Yeah.
Yeah, or a special symbol, as it says here.
No, we are not talking about the special values. It will only store the on or off. But the maximum possible values it can store 256 values. Because one bit can hold 2 values, yeah, and 2 bits can hold how many values?
4.
4, how?
How?
Yeah. So one bit can store?
1 or
values,
0?
And 2 bits can store like a 1 and 1 or 1 or 0 or 0 or 1 or 0, 0. 4 values.
Yeah.
Yeah. And 3 bits can store
6 values. Although 3 bits, I don't know, but I would suppose it's yeah, 6.
Do you know the powers and multiplications?
Yeah. Oh, so it's 8. If it's multiplied, yeah.
Eight. So 3 bits can store 8 values.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And 4 bits can store 16 values.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So the sequence will be starting. That's a kind of 2 to the power 2 and 2 to the power 3 to the power 4. So in this sequence, so a byte can store, you know, when you put like 8, then probably you are doing like a 2 times, 3 times, 3 bits making 8, yeah, 4 times making 16, 5 times making 32,
64,
6 times making 64, 7 times making 128,
mm-hmm.
and 8 times making 256, yeah. So that's the logic behind, you know, every time you go to the market, you say, oh, I have got a, you know, drive of, you know, 256 GB.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And you have got a 512 GB. Yeah. You never find, you know, a complete, you know, 1000 GB. It's always.
Yeah.
And remember that when you say 1 MB, it doesn't mean that 1 MB is 1,000, you know, bytes. Yeah.
No,
but it is always 1024. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So from the basic, if you know, the unit is starting from the bit, it keeps on increasing into the bytes, megabytes, gigabytes. You know,
mm-hmm.
terabytes. What is the unit after the terabyte?
Terabyte. 1024 gigabytes.
No, what is the next unit of the after the terabyte?
Of the terabyte.
It's a petabyte.
Beta.
Yeah, petabyte.
Oh, I didn't know that.
So the it's all the game about the bits. It's not the Bitcoin, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Have you heard about the Bitcoin as well?
Yeah, I'm familiar.
Yeah, you're familiar, but the game starts from, you know, a bit.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so let me go ahead further, yeah. Word is 16 bits, double word 32 bits. Kilobyte is never 1,000, but it's 1024 bytes. Yeah, because when you will be multiplying and giving a power of 2, then you are getting, you know, multiples of 2. So we made like a 256. 256 multiplied by 2 will be at 512, and 512 multiplied by 2 will make a 1024. Is that clear?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and megabyte is basically the 10 24 kilobytes. You multiply 1024 with 1024, it makes a 1 megabyte. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And similar way, a gigabyte is basically the 1024 megabyte. Yeah. So everywhere mm-hmm. there is a game of 1024. Okay.
Yeah.
So like, you know, these calculation, if I will be doing the calculation, it will take a longer. So, if, you know, you need to do your calculations later on whenever you are, you have a sufficient time. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
Then you have a terabyte. It's a 1024 gigabyte. When you say I've got a 1 terabyte hard drive, it means you have a 1000 of gigabytes normally, mm-hmm. but it's not the 1000, but it's, you know, the 1024 gigabytes. Yeah.
Okay.
Now, standard methods of input like a keyboard and mouse, few more inputs like a trackball, trackpads, integrated point devices like a pen drive and many things. Yeah.
Yeah.
Alternative methods of input, device for hand, optical input devices, audiovisual devices for the hand, pens, touch screen. Then output devices, monitors, printers, speakers, plotters. Peripheral devices, they are connected with the computer like CD-ROM, keyboard, mouse. Mm-hmm. You know, I'm just going quickly and you can read them in detail. Is that okay? Yeah.
Yeah, sure. Yeah.
Network types. Local area network, wide area network, and wireless local area network, metropolitan area network. So these are definitions you must be aware from, you know, few of them, and you might not have a chance to read the others, you know, but they exist. They are called like that. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
Like SEN, CAN, FEN, LAN. Sorry.
Most of them I know.
Yeah, normally we use a LAN, WAN, WLAN, something, yeah. So local area network, they are within a building. Wide area network is a geographically, it can be anywhere, and it can be a combination of the LANs as well as WANs, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So WAN is normally, you know, the kind of internet.
Yeah.
Because WAN is a network of LANs, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Other type of networks like these, wireless local area network, on Wi-Fi, wireless networks. When you say wireless local area network, it means a LAN within a house based on the Wi-Fi. Like when you say you have a home Wi-Fi, then all computers connected to the one router, they would form a wireless local area network.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And the metropolitan area network, like network spanning a physical area larger than a LAN but a smaller than a WAN, such as a city. A MAN is typically owned and operated by a single entity, such as a government body or a large corporation, or maybe, you know, the banks. The banks, you know, they use the network, and they can have their own network.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So these are some definitions about the different types of the networks. Hardware infrastructure, anything you know that you use, maybe the any components, the network network connectivity, communication, operations of a network. So that's a hardware infrastructure that you use. Like in hardware, for a network, you normally use router, switches, LAN cards, wireless routers, cables.
Mm-hmm.
The networking infrastructure, networking softwares may include network operations and management, operating systems, firewalls, network security applications. You might be aware with all these things like operating system, firewall, and applications. Are you aware of these, some of them?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Softwares might be for monitoring, bandwidth analysis, IP, address management, troubleshooting tools. So obviously there are the networking softwares as well. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And limitations of the computer, like computers cannot think. Is that true?
Yeah, indeed.
Computers cannot accept
from quantum or AI. The basic computer, yeah, cannot think.
Even the robots or any of the intelligent computers, they don't think at all. They have been fed to think.
Mm-hmm.
They have a kind of rules. They have been told the rules, and they take only from these rules. Those the robots or anything, like talking robots, even they don't think. They mm-hmm. only interpret whatever has been fed to them. Yeah.
Okay,
like,
yeah.
Did you watch the latest, the Spider-Man?
Yeah.
Yeah. Like, he activated the training mode.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So whatever the training mode was, activated, then that mode was not as a thinking. The guide was, she was telling her, but that was, stored to her.
Mm-hmm.
So anyways. So cannot decide anything until you give them any interpretation, cannot express their ideas. Computers cannot implement by themselves. So expandable computers that can be, expanded, can be increased, like scalability of the computer, like, the cloud computing. You might have heard about it, must have heard about it. Yeah. So that makes expandable computers. So you can, study more about expandable computers, maybe not into this unit, but it is, about the cloud computing, the scalability of the computing. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So limitations of the computing, we discuss the softwares used in the networking, hardware infrastructure, types of the networks we discussed. And peripheral devices, input-output devices, and we discussed the memory measuring units, and from the 0-1 to the gigabytes and terabytes and petabytes. We discussed the types of the memory, the secondary memory, which fall into three categories, and overall the two types of the memory, that's RAM and ROM, and we discuss the central processing unit, discuss about its components of the central processing unit, and discuss the definition of the software, discuss the hardware itself, and a computer definition itself. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So I hope, as I already explained, that you must have known these definitions earlier, but if you look at the types of the software and the memory measuring units, and few more definitions that were really interesting to know, and they were easy, but every person doesn't know about them at all.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, like a sequential one, like the random access, they have some sense behind, isn't it?
I know, but the thing with me is that I know stuff, but not by definition.
Yeah,
like, I can tell you something or describe you something, but if you ask me directly about the definition, I won't be able to tell. So
yeah, that's the purpose of these, getting these degrees and these certificates. They teach you from the basics, and basics like that a pure computer student should know these things.
All right.
Yeah, that's why there is a difference between the pure computer scientist and other IT, the people who use the IT. Yeah.
Yeah.
And that's why they need a qualification. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Makes sense.
Okay. Yeah, of course.
So anything else you want to ask apart from this, unit?
No, I don't think so. I'm clear. I'm okay.
Okay. So we end up this session, and probably what we do, we will be having about two sessions in a week. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So that we should be able to cover as much as, units, so that you should be working on the assignments. And, you can start to write the assignments on the this unit as well, but let us complete this first in the next lesson, and let me check my availability as well as your schedule that you have given to me, and probably this week I will let you know the another session, and hopefully everything will go smooth, and you don't forget to work on the assignments. The assessment is purely based on the assignments that you will be writing, and we will assess it, and once the assignments will be educate and proper,
mm-hmm.
and then you will be able to get the certificate. Yeah,
all right.
So okay, I I close the session now, and see you soon in a couple of days, but I would definitely let you know. Yeah,
all right. Yeah,
all right. Thank you, Nicholas. Bye. Thank you. Bye.
Have a nice day. Bye.
Thank you. Bye.